Hello everyone, this is Sam Spade. Welcome to another Coding Fundamentals in GML 2.3.1 tutorial. And in this tutorial, we're going to be talking about the garbage collector. Now, what is a garbage collector? In fact, I almost didn't do this tutorial at all, because this is, after all, a series about the fundamentals. And at least in GML, understanding the garbage collector may or may not be considered fundamental. But to understand the garbage collector, you have to understand a little bit about memory management. And that I thought was worth talking about, at least a little bit at a high level. So all programs have to do some form of memory management. Memory is not unlimited. You have a certain amount of available memory. And every time you create almost anything, variables, instances, structs, functions, etc., you use some of that available memory. And the more you use, the less there is. So if you never free up that memory, you eventually run out and your program would crash. So your program needs a way of knowing which memory is not being used and getting rid of it. Now, in most modern languages, allocating and deallocating memory, taking and freeing memory, is done automatically. And this is true with GameMaker. However, in many older languages and some modern languages, memory management is not automatic. You have to do it manually. And if that sounds like extra work, it definitely is, but it comes with a big advantage. The big advantage to manual memory management is that your programs are a lot more efficient and faster. And if you're making a AAA game that looks like this, that's probably really important. However, for most indie games, efficiency and speed is less important than just being able to make it. And so automatic memory management is really nice. And one way that automatic memory management frees up memory is through a garbage collector. There are other methods, but a garbage collector is a big one, and it's what GameMaker uses. So what is GameMaker's garbage collector? Well, you mostly don't actually need to worry about it. This is a direct quote from the manual, which I think is worth paying attention to. In general, you should never need to interact with the GameMaker Studio 2 garbage collection system. But some of the GML commands are available to give you information about it and to influence its behavior to a limited degree. And I think this is worth taking to heart. Even though it's worth understanding a little bit about what's going on in the background about managing memory, you probably shouldn't be messing with the garbage collector. But if you want to, here's what GameMaker allows you to do. Number one, it has a couple functions that get you info. GC get stat, GC is enabled, and GC get target frame time. These are pretty self-explanatory, I think, and you can read more about them in the manual. GameMaker also has several functions that allow you to control how the garbage collector works. They are GC target frame time, which allows you to set how much time the garbage collector is supposed to spend per frame. And then you have GC enable, which allows you to turn it on or off, and GC collect, which will force the garbage collector to run at the end of the frame, even if it is currently disabled. So what does turning the garbage collector off actually do, or what won't be collected if it's off? So if you turn it off, the garbage collector will no longer clean up methods, structs, arrays, instances, sequences, or animation curves. And instances, sequences, and animation curves are highlighted because there's something special about them. With methods, structs, and arrays, there's really no way for you to manually delete them. GameMaker just handles these automatically. Now, with structs, you do have the delete keyword, and I do have a tutorial on that. There should be a link up above. So if you want to know more about what the delete keyword does with structs, you can watch that. But just in general, there isn't a way to actually destroy a method, a struct, or an array. But instances, sequences, and animation curves have to be destroyed before GameMaker will garbage collect it. Now, instances that aren't persistent will be destroyed automatically on room change. Sequences that are made inside of the IDE will also be destroyed on room change. And you don't really need to destroy animation curves that are made in the room editor. But sequences and animation curves created through code do need to be destroyed in order for the garbage collector to collect them. So in summary, you don't really need to worry about the GameMaker garbage collector. In fact, you probably shouldn't worry about it. You probably shouldn't be messing with it at all. But it's worth knowing the way that memory management, in a sort of general sense, is going on behind the scenes, even if you aren't going to interact with it. And of course, there may be times where you want to mess with it in order to improve efficiency. I do have all of these links below, and this is one of those times where I would definitely recommend going and watching some of them. In fact, I'm going to talk about each of them specifically. I think it's worth reading the Wikipedia article on how garbage collection works and its pros and cons. I've also linked to a very general explanation about garbage collection, not by me. And of course, you have the garbage collection page in the manual and a forum post in the GameMaker community by Nocturne, Mark Alexander, who used to write the manual for GameMaker. I'd highly recommend looking at all of these, and of course the links to the slides are below as well. And that's it. Thanks for watching.